I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 41.1. Questioner, I have one question of logistics to start with. I know that is a dumb question, but I have to ask it to be sure. There is a possibility that we may have to move from this location. Will this have any effect at all on our contact with Ra? Answer, I am Ra. This is not a foolish question. The location is meaningless, for are we not in the creation? However, the place of the working shall be either carefully adjudged by yourselves to be of the appropriate vibratory levels, or it shall be suggested that the purification of the place be enacted and dedication made through meditation before initial working. This might entail such seemingly mundane chores as the cleansing or painting of surfaces which you may deem to be inappropriately marred. Question 41.2. Questioner, I am familiar with the banishing ritual of the lesser pentagram. I was wondering if this ritual was of use in preparing a place for this type of working. Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 41.3. Questioner, in trying to build an understanding from the start, you might say, starting with intelligent infinity and getting to our present condition of being, I think that I should go back and investigate our sun, since it is the sublogos that creates all that we experience in this particular planetary system. Will you give me a description of our sun? Answer, I am Ra. This is a query which is not easily answered in your language, for the sun has various aspects in relation to intelligent infinity, to intelligent energy, and to each density of each planet, as you call these spheres. Moreover, these differences extend into the metaphysical or time-space part of your creation. In relationship to intelligent infinity, the sun body is, equally with all parts of the infinite creation, part of that infinity. In relation to the potentiated intelligent infinity which makes use of intelligent energy, it is the offspring, shall we say, of the logos for a much larger number of sublogwa. The relationship is hierarchical in that the sublogos uses the intelligent energy in ways set forth by the logos and uses its free will to co-create the, shall we say, full nuances of your densities as you experience them. In relationship to the densities, the sun body may physically, as you would say, be seen to be a large body of gaseous elements undergoing the processes of fusion and radiating heat and light. Metaphysically, the sun achieves a meaning to 4th through 7th density according to the growing abilities of entities in these densities to grasp the living creation and call entity, or other self, nature of this sun body. Thus by the 6th density the sun may be visited and inhabited by those dwelling in time-space and may even be partially created from moment to moment by the processes of 6th density entities in their evolution. Question 41.4. Questioner, in your last statement did you mean that the 6th density entities are actually creating manifestations of the sun in their density? Could you explain what you meant by that? Answer, I am Ra. In this density, some entities whose means of reproduction is fusion may choose to perform this portion of experience as part of the beingness of the sun body. Thus you may think of portions of the light that you receive as offspring of the generative expression of 6th density love. Question 41.5. Questioner, then could you say that 6th density entities are using that mechanism to be the more closely co-creators with the infinite creator? Answer, I am Ra. This is precisely correct as seen in the latter portions of 6th density seeking the experiences of the gateway density. Question 41.6. Questioner, thank you. What I want to do now is investigate, as the 1st density is formed, what happens and how energy centers are first formed in beings. Does it make any sense to ask you if the sun itself has a density, or is it all densities? Answer, I am Ra. The sublogos is of the entire octave and is not that entity which experiences the learning teachings of entities such as yourselves. Question 41.7. Questioner, I am going to make a statement of my understanding and ask you to correct me. I intuitively see the first density being formed by an energy center, which is a vortex. This vortex then causes these spinning motions that I have mentioned before of vibration, which is light, which then starts to condense into materials of the first density. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct as far as your reasoning has taken you. However, it is well to point out that the Logos has the plan of all the densities of the octave in potential completion before entering the space-time continuum in first density. Thus the energy centers exist before they are manifest. Question 41.8. Questioner, then what is the simplest being that has manifested? I am supposing that it might be a single cell or something like that. How does it function with respect to energy centers? Answer, I am Ra. The simplest manifest being is light, or what you have called the photon. In relationship to energy centers, it may be seen to be the center or foundation of all articulated energy fields. Question 41.9. Questioner, when first density is formed, we have fire, air, earth, and water. There is at some time the first movement or individuation of life into a portion of consciousness that is self-mobile. Could you describe the process of the creation of this and what type of energy center it has? Answer, I am Ra. The first ray density, though attracted towards growth, is not in the proper vibration for those conditions conducive to what you may call the spark of awareness. As the vibratory energies move from red to orange, the vibratory environment is such as to stimulate those chemical substances which lately had been inert to combine in such a fashion that love and light begin the function of growth. The supposition which you had earlier made concerning single-celled entities such as the polymorphous dinaflagellate is correct. The mechanism is one of the attraction of upward spiraling light. There is nothing random about this or any portion of evolution. Question 41.10. Questioner, as I remember, the polymorphous dinaflagellate is an iron rather than a copper-based cell. Could you comment on that? Answer, I am Ra. This information is not central. The base of any metabolism, shall we say, is that which may be found in the chemical substances of the neighborhood of origin. Question 41.11. Questioner, I was just commenting on this because it has the motion of our animal life with copper-based cells, yet it is the iron-based cell of plant life, indicating a transition from possibly plant to animal life. Am I wrong? My memory is a little fuzzy on this. Answer, I am Ra. It is not that you are incorrect, but that no conclusions should be drawn from such information. There are several different types of bases for conscious entities, not only upon this planetary sphere but to a much greater extent in the forms found on planetary spheres of other sublogua. The chemical vehicle is that which most conveniently houses the consciousness. The functioning of consciousness is the item of interest rather than the chemical makeup of a physical vehicle. We have observed that those whom you call scientists have puzzled over the various differences and possible interrelationships of various stages, types, and conditions of life forms. This is not fruitful material, as it is that which is of a moment's choice by your sublogos. Question 41.12. Questioner, I didn't mean to waste time with that question, but you just happened to mention that particular single cell. Does this polymorphous dinaflagellate have an orange energy center? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 41.13. Questioner, is this energy center, then, on a very small scale related to the orange energy center in man? Answer, I am Ra. The true color is precisely the same. However, the consciousness of the second density beginning is primitive, and the use of orange ray limited to the expression of self, which may be seen to be the movement and survival. In third density, at this time, those clinging to orange ray have a much more complex system of distortions through which orange ray is manifested. This is somewhat complicated. We shall endeavor to simplify. The appropriate true color for third density is, as you have ascertained, yellow. However, the influences of the true color, green, acting upon yellow ray entities have caused many entities to revert to the consideration of self rather than the stepping forward into consideration of other self or green ray. This may not be seen to be of a negatively polarized nature, as the negatively polarized entity is working very intensively with the deepest manifestations of yellow ray group energies, especially the manipulations of other self for service to self. Those reverting to orange ray, and we may add these are many upon your plane at this time, are those who feel the vibrations of true color green and, therefore, respond by rejecting governmental and societal activities as such and seek once more the self. However, not having developed the yellow ray properly so that it balances the personal vibratory rates of the entity then is faced with the task of further activation and balancing of the self in relation to the self, thus the orange ray manifestations at this space-time nexus. Thus true color orange is that which it is without difference. However, the manifestations of this or any ray may be seen to be the most various depending upon the vibratory levels and balances of the mind-body or mind-body-spirit complexes which are expressing these energies.